If you're happy with that,
yes,
good luck.
Absolutely. Big surprise, we did really well and lost.
Yeah.
How many times have we had this happen?
I didn't see this coming. I really didn't.
I was surprised. I thought they would bring more to the table.
I really thought we had this one in the bag. You explain the design as going back into history of the UAE, and the Brits have a design that's very modern.
I'm still really, really pissed off that we lost, and I am therefore nominating Steve to go home. I think he's an irresponsible designer who keeps on getting away with murder. Keeps on doing these stupid, childish, incomplete designs, and he keeps winning.
Can I go for Matt?
And personally, that pisses me off.
Steve, do you have a response for that?
Fortunately, Steve isn't here. There's no way that I'm going to vote for any of you, and I can't fault any of you for any of what happened. The only thing I can do is fault myself. Being the team leader, I'm the logical choice. I failed. Maybe I should have designed a more modern building. So I vote for myself.
There was no fault on your part.
Yes. I don't want to go home, but I do nominate myself.
No, I understand. I do.
One of the reasons, actually, I couldn't really focus on the task, it was because I was so irritated being next to you. You talk a lot of shit about all of us. I think you're the one misrepresented all of us to British team. I do not think you're professional. I do not think you're smart. You do not offer much. So I'm going to vote for you.
Does anybody else have a nomination?
I made my decision when I received a phone call from Mojé last night. She apologized for our last fire. And I was waiting for that apology, and I respect her for that. And I feel like we can move forward and work together professionally from here on out. So at this point, I feel like you're more of a liability on our team because I don't feel like I can trust you. So I would vote for you.
From the last fire to the last two missions, I'm really torn from what happened at the last fire. What really bothered me was when she said she was gonna screw all of us eventually.
I did not say I'm gonna screw you all. I said I'm here to compete. And if you wanna call it the screwing, call it screwing. I have no problem
maybe
with that.
Maybe you did say that.
Just wait.
You did say you were gonna
then maybe
you
I, that
and
was.
You.
And y'all, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. I'm gonna screw each and every one. But besides that, just let me keep elaborating.
Did I?
Yeah.
Yeah. And she's a good saleswoman. She's good at being nice to people, buttering them up, and getting what she wants. And then she'll stick her high heel through your neck in 5 seconds if it suits her just fine.
Then I meant it.
So Brian, give it to us.
I'm gonna stay strong with my vote that I've wanted for the past 2 weeks. I'm still gonna vote for Mojé.
Thank you.
I feel
Brian.
That's the right vote in my heart.
Good.
She hopes to fire me first. And then pick off Brian, and then pick off Shawnee, and then pick off Richard last second and stick her high heel right through his neck.
We meet again.
Well, guys, what a turnaround. I'm not going to call you the architect tonight. Shawnee, I don't even know what to call you. I've often thought of calling you G.I. Jeff, but I'm not going to go there either.
Here he goes again.
Moji, I'm not going to call you a one-trick pony tonight, and I'm not going to call you the Joker. I am going to let Matt take my place.
Hey, good looking. That was a secret handshake.
Like a groom.
I have no doubt whatsoever that there is a wealth of talent stood here before me, and that whatever happens in the course of this competition, I'm sure there's some very bright futures ahead for all of you. Truthfully, I question whether those futures are in international real estate for a number of you. Shawnee.
Yes, ma'am.
You led the first task for the American team, but you haven't led a task since.
Actually, to be quite honest, because of the dynamic of our team for the past several missions, I felt that Richard might be a better leader to work with Moshe and Jeff. And I felt that I would contribute with my expertise as a team player, and Brian and I would work together.
Brian.
Yes, sir.
You voted for Moshe to be eliminated.
I did. I voted for Moshe because I feel from a couple tasks ago there's been some major issues, and it's been making the group feel uncomfortable. Removing her would bring us closer together.
How do you feel when you hear that from Brian?
It doesn't bother me.
You want to be an international business leader, I assume.
I am already.
You want to be?
I am already. I want to be Dr. Fame's partner.
I'm not so sure.
But I am already an international real estate person. I think you deserve to be there because you did not earn it, Matt. So you got a bonus tonight. So you better be careful about what you're saying.
What somebody who is in your team is effectively saying is that you are not displaying the qualities that you would expect from
this
a leader.
This is a competition.
Which someone who demonstrates leadership qualities will win. Of that, I have no doubt. And I'm
sure you don't
mind.
Choose their own people, Matt. They recruit their own talents, and I'm very good at it. So that doesn't mean I'm not a good leader if I don't get along with my teammates to clear
I would
that.
I beg to differ. Let's see what other people think.
It's very different.
Jeff, please could you summarize for me how you perceive Moshe's leadership?
Well, I would probably echo what you say, and I don't think you always can choose your team members. Or the people who work for you. It depends upon the structure within you, which you work, but leadership, I think, cuts across all facets of your life, and not just within a business that you may run, but in every part of who you are.
You haven't had that experience, Jeff, so you better not make any comment on that.
Moshe is an expert on my life, so, yeah.
Would you work for Moshe outside of the context of this competition?
I wouldn't want him to work for me.
Yeah, I don't think so, no.
Richard, just a week ago, we were sitting here on the helipad, and you reminded the British that there's a dramatic turnaround taking place. What's your current perspective on that issue?
Well, I'm hoping that what I said at the helipad last week sunk in, and that you all have not you, but other members of your team have learned to be gracious winners. And yes, we've lost again. And surprised, I think, unfairly well, because I thought our design was better than yours. And actually, you're being so nice to us tonight. I'd like to offer you a gift. This is very much in line with what we're talking about right now, about design. And Shawnee, would you hold this, please?
Yeah, absolutely.
This is a special gift from us to you, and it's about design. These are the salt and pepper shakers from the hotel restaurant. When put side by side, they look just like the building you guys designed. So this is a message for your designer, for Steve on your team, and I hope that he'll find a better source for inspiration when he's dealing with his clients. I'll save it for later.
Jeff, you have been quoted as saying earlier on in the competition, why am I here? Have you answered that question yet?
When I first came here, it was for the adventure, for the experience, to try something new, so.
When you say a career, I think of someone working for somebody else. I don't think of somebody who is intending on starting up their own business. Was that a slip of the tongue?
No, I agree with you.
Thank you for your honesty. Moshe.
Matt.
Can you tell me, what is it that you do want?
I want to be Dr. Fame's partner.
Can you tell me why you want to be Dr. Fame's partner?
I think you know why. I think everyone knows why by now. Because I have the desire, I have the experience, and I am a real entrepreneur.
You want to win for yourself?
I don't even understand your question. Of course I'm gonna win for myself. Aren't you here to win for yourself? You're here to win for somebody else?
I've got the answer I wanted, thank you. Here comes Dr. Fahim. I'm just going to speak to him, and then I'll be back shortly.
Good evening, Doctor.
Good evening, Matt. How was the Americans outside?
They were very well behaved, actually. I was surprised. I expected them to be more fiery than they were. Mojo, for example, admitted that she wants to win the competition for herself. I thought that was interesting.
And tell me, what do you think about Richard?
On the basis of what I know about him, seriously consider him as a partner.
Whom did they vote for?
They voted, the American team,
yes,
voted for Jeff.
For Jeff. What do you think about Jeff?
I think Jeff is a very outstanding individual. I think he is someone who is finding his way at the moment and discovering what it is he wants to do in the next chapter of his life.
And whom did the British team vote for?
We voted for Jeff.
Why is that? For the same reason?
Well, we're conscious of that, we're mindful of that, but obviously our strategy is to weaken the American team to some extent.
But I was really impressed by Richard's job. Don't you think it's better that you agree with me? I have to eliminate two, one British, one American?
No, absolutely not. You want to really want a healthy competition.
He has done a great job, and you just admit that.
So do you think...
Tell me whom you want to eliminate from your team?
Absolutely not.
If you had the opportunity to eliminate one, it's going to be Steve or Layla?
No. I'm going to be moving forward in the next round with both Steve and Layla.
My decision is? Please.
Thank you. I've just had a very interesting conversation with Dr. Fahim, and he's made his final decision. To whoever receives the pink slip tonight, I wish the very best of luck for their future. Mojo. Please get in the car, you are safe.
Thank you.
Don't give me one of those cards.
Richard. Can you also take your seat in the car, please?
Don't run me over.
Brian,
yes?
You're free to join them.
Thank you.
chef. You have my best wishes.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Good call.
Matt asked me a very good question. He asked me, you are looking for a career, a job. And I said, I agree.
I know you want a Mojay.
It's all right, Jeff. I'll settle for it. Jeff's better than nothing.
Do you know why Jeff had to go home? He didn't do anything in the last assignment.
I've learned a lot about myself, about the Middle East. I do hope to remain here and work. And I really don't know what the future holds, but I'll do my best, so.
I cannot have a partner who doesn't have this kind of skills.
You're the boss.